Hi everyone, Aryan at gamedevbox here. Today we are diving into something really cool, how to create an animated cursor in Unity. Whether you are working on a 2D or 3D game, adding an animated cursor can really enhance your player's experience. Let's get it started. First, you will need a sequence of images for your cursor animation. For example, I have PNGs that represent an attacking cursor and a loading cursor. Make sure to set the texture type to cursor, disable read and write, use consistent cursor size like 128 by 128, 64 by 64 or 32 by 32 pixels. If you are using sprite sheets, don't forget to slice them in Unity. I have already created three scripts and I will explain each one. Let's start with the animated cursor script. Attach this script to an object. Let's create an empty cursor manager game object and add the script to it. In the inspector, you will see it needs cursor frames. Provide the images for your animation and frame rate. This controls the speed of the animation. Lower values mean faster animations. It works great. Now let's dive into the code. In the animated cursor script, we store the cursor frames in a texture2D array. In the start method, we set the first frame of the animation. In update, we check the timing based on the frame rate, set the next frame, and call the setCursor function. It's that simple. What if you want the animated cursor to change when hovering over specific objects or layers? I know you might need more control for your game, so I have created two additional scripts, Multi-Cursor Handler 2D and Multi-Cursor Handler 3D. Use the appropriate raycasting for 2D or 3D games. So if your game is 2D, use the 2D one, and if 3D, use the Multi-Cursor Handler 3D. For my current setup, I will use the 2D version. Attach the multi-cursor handler 2D script to your cursor manager and let's delete the animated cursor script. In the multi-cursor handler 2D script, interactable layers, these are the layers the script will check. For example, I have created two layers, enemy and obstacles. The script will raycast to detect objects on these layers. Cursor animations add animations as unique elements. Name each animation, attack cursor, loading cursor. Assign the cursor frames and frame rates. Specify the object tags for each animation. For example, attack cursor works only for objects with the enemy tag. Loading cursor works for objects with doors and boxes tags. Make sure to create these tags in Unity. This could be totally different for you. Before we play the scene, one important note is add colliders to your objects. Use 2D colliders for 2D objects or 3D colliders for 3D objects. The raycast needs something to hit. When we play the game, you will see the animated cursor changes for different objects. Let's look at the multi-cursor handler 2D code. We created an extra class called cursorAnimation2D and serialize it for use in the inspector. The script stores an array of cursor animation 2D objects. In update, it recasts for objects on the specific layers. If it hits something, it checks the objects tags and finds the corresponding animation using nested loops. If an animation is found, it runs the animation. Otherwise, it resets the cursor to default. If your default cursor is a specific image, you can modify the script to set it instead of null. I didn't add this feature, but it's a great homework assignment if your project needs it. The multi-cursor handler 3D script works the same way, but uses 3D raycasting. I have uploaded all the scripts we talked about today to my GitHub, so feel free to grab them and explore. You will find the link in the description below. And that's it. With just a bit of scripting, you can add polished animated cursors to your Unity project. If you found this tutorial helpful, make sure to like, subscribe, and drop a comment if you have questions or ideas for future videos. Thanks for watching, and as always, keep creating amazing games.